For way too long, we've been stuck with Vega when it comes to integrated graphics in AMD APUs. Don't get me wrong, back in February of 2018, when AMD released their Raven Ridge APUs, the Ryzen 5 2400G and 2200G, Vega crushed everything. But not a lot has changed since then. Even AMD's current fastest APU, the Ryzen 7 5700G, still uses the same old Vega graphics architecture. This is about to change. The rumors on AMD's upcoming Ryzen 6000 Rembrandt-based APUs are getting more concrete, and they're exciting. I'm talking Zen3 Plus, RDNA 2 DDR5 and low-power DDR5, and a new 6nm design. If you want to know how Rembrandt will change everything and why we got stuck with Vega for so long, then this video is for you. To understand how much of a leap forward Rembrandt will be, you first have to realize how long AMD has been stuck with Vega. Not only did AMD use Vega since Raven Ridge, the amount of shader cores has been reduced over time too. While the 2400G had a Vega 11 GPU with 704 shader cores, the Ryzen 7 5700G has a Vega 8 GPU with only 512 shaders. That's a reduction of 28%. To be fair with AMD, they improved the performance of their smaller Vega 8 GPUs by increasing the clock speed from 1250 MHz to 2000 MHz, which is an increase of 60%. This increase was mostly made possible by using advanced production nodes. Still, that doesn't change the fact that AMD did decrease the amount of shader cores over time. But why would AMD do that? There's a good reason for AMD's decision, and it has to do with the same thing that allows Rembrandt to be a lot faster in the future: memory bandwidth. GPUs are hungry for bandwidth to feed their shaders, and the available bandwidth hasn't changed much since Raven Ridge. Current APUs are still running on the AM4 socket using DDR4 memory. At some point, it just doesn't make sense to increase the amount of GPU cores if the GPU is limited by memory bandwidth anyways. So when AMD realized their new 7nm process node will allow them to clock their integrated Vega graphics card a lot higher, it didn't make any sense to stick with the larger Vega 11 configuration, because the Vega 8 configuration would deliver comparable performance. Both parts are limited by the bandwidth the memory would provide. But enough about these old chips. You are here for news about Rembrandt. Let's take a look at what makes Rembrandt so exciting. First, a quick overview of what we know about Rembrandt so far. It will support up to 8 Zen3 Plus CPU cores, have a RDNA 2 base graphics solution, support DDR5 and low power DDR5, and will be produced in a TSMC 6nm node. But before you get too excited about the Zen3 Plus name, it's most likely just a 6nm version of the same old Zen3 cores, maybe with a little bit higher clock speeds and some silicon improvements. Not to be confused with the upcoming Zen3D. The switch to the TSMC N6 node makes a lot of sense for AMD here, because it's design compatible with N7, so they don't have to redesign their Zen cores, and at the same time it delivers up to 18% more logic density, meaning the chips will turn out smaller. A lot more important for Rembrandt will be the graphics performance, and here AMD will make the switch from Vega to RDNA2, which is a lot more efficient and supports the latest APIs, most likely including hardware ray tracing, though I wouldn't expect a lot of ray tracing performance about an APU. Upgrading the GPU IP to RDNA2 is nice, but where it gets even more exciting is the supported memory. The leaked user benchmark entry uses very conservative DDR5 4800, but from earlier leaks we know that Rembrandt will support up to low power DDR5 6400. This is the same RAM Apple is using for the new M1 Pro and Max SoCs, so it's pretty fast. An interesting comparison for Rembrandt is the upcoming Valve Steam Deck. It's based on the Van Gogh APU, which combines 4 Zen 2 cores with up to 8 RDNA 2 compute units, clocked at 1.6 GHz, and it uses low-power DDR5 5500 as its system memory. Now, we can be pretty certain that Valve and AMD made absolutely sure that the Van Gogh APU isn't bandwidth limited. The combination of 8 RDNA2 based compute units at 1.6 GHz with low-power DDR5 5500 should be pretty balanced. And from there, we can derive some first performance estimates for Rembrandt. If 8 RDNA2 compute units at 1.6 GHz are not limited by 88 GB of bandwidth, then Rembrandt with its 102 GB of bandwidth should deliver at least 16% more performance just based on the memory calculation alone. My guess would be that Rembrandt will use the same configuration as Van Gogh with 8 RDNA 2 based compute units, but it will clock a lot higher. The leaked sample was running on the SP7 socket, which is a mobile setup. It could be something like a future Ryzen 7 6800H or 6800U. But Rembrandt won't stay mobile only, there will also be a desktop version, most likely coming with the socket AM5. The mobile parts will be released first, early 2022 is a good guess, and the desktop parts will come sometimes later. If we are lucky, maybe AM5 will be launched with Rembrandt before the introduction of Zen4. Now, there are two main reasons why I am excited about Rembrandt-based APUs. Number one is that we will most likely get the first actual performance improvements for APUs since 2018. Just the thought of modern games running at decent speed in 1080p is pretty amazing. Number two is the ongoing GPU shortage. Some analysts even say it might last well into 2023. Even the cheapest options right now, the RX 6600 or the RTX 3060, are priced well beyond most people's means. So a capable APU could allow a lot of gamers to build a decent system without breaking the bank. So is Rembrandt the perfect gaming APU? If you ask me, there's a really good chance it will be pretty close to perfect. But in my opinion, for a perfect APU, it will also need the 3D stack treatment. I'm absolutely positive the integrated RDNA 2 graphics would really, really love some stacked L3 cache. It's just a little hint for AMD. If you found this video interesting, don't forget to leave a like, subscribe and ring the bell so you won't miss any future content, and see you next time.